show up in that round. You know, interestingly, Joystick's name is actually not like just Joystick. It's like the Russian word for opera and then the Russian word for insane or something along those lines combined.
I did not know that.
Yeah, it's really interesting. Because he was big time opera back in games he used to play.
Oh.
Really good ace there from Joystick, and I mean, there's not really much else to say about that round. He ran around the map and he killed a bunch of people.
Or Sledge's hammer. This is fine.
They're actually going because they can actually get to the objective rather than waiting outside.
All right, and then we should also talk about the other elephant in the room, which was the spawn peaks. One of your favorite things to address.
Yeah, after the closet window in Villa, sprint yeet the C4 towards fountains. I learned from that one quite well. So what we've done is we've gone through and we've looked at all of the runouts and the runout possibilities, and we've made sure that anyone that wants to...
Ball is rolling down the hill, and who from Empire can stop the momentum? Well, it's Scyther. He pops up, he's completely detected, and Gogo is removed from action. Your hard breacher is down. Scyther right now, oh, what a C4 that is! And a double kill once again. Scyther so good. Shepard will get his own, downing Uno, and it's all Pengu. It's what? A third for Scyther. This is outlandish! Scyther, my man, 4 kills! And around that look like we...
Cross, we indeed love seeing it.
Oh no.
I love how he's wearing the Chonka helmet. Dude, my immersion right now, all time high.
Oh!
Oh, he flipped the helmet!
Oh my god!
Let's hear it!
Oh! 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 Please, please, just one!
Take the duel!
Just one! Do it! Do it!
No!
Right! No!
The turret falls again.
Shots, it's a 1v1 up against Shroud. Priest on a controller up against one of the most skilled players with an MNK.
Can he win out this gunfight? This will be something truly crazy.
This is the final battle of mouse and keyboard versus controller right here.
Exactly, exactly. Priest trying to take it to the house right now, trying to prove them all wrong. Shroud's going to take a little bit of damage. This is for all the console players at home right now. You can tell all your PC friends to shut their mouth. He can possibly win out this gunfight. It's going to be a quick rotation. He had the skeleton key pressuring through. Doesn't have time, and no!
Oh, so close. He had the angle and everything. Just couldn't control the spray at the end of the day. So Shroud picks it up.
What?
What are you guys making with these things?
Every time we go back to the crowd, there's some new creation.
We've seen a sushi roll.
Empire, but they've only got 42 seconds to make it happen. And gonna open up that front door. Joystick going with the lifelines into the freezer. The gas canisters are stalling them out. Dan has to do a better job of pressuring the smoke, but it's actually gonna be Scyther to get the nade onto that smoke, freeing things up for Empire. But there's only 28 seconds. That's not a lot to work with. Pushed by the main bar, Joystick will not see anybody as the fallback has already been called from G2. One at coat check, but he's down. A beautiful shot from Dan, and Scyther gets one as well. Joystick adds, and it's all Fabian. In the attacker's favor, then Empire is sitting pretty on this map. But of course, that would only be their second in the series, and well, they're gonna need 3 to win it outright. After this, we will certainly be going to map number 4, and that will be, as you mentioned earlier.
No.
Coastline.
No.
Yep.
No, don't cheer!
It's happening. It's right after this, guys. And we're definitely gonna go there. The only question is...
You know, I was wondering how the crowd was gonna react given the fact that all of the NA teams got bounced in the first day. And not just that, but the more popular NA teams, some of them didn't even make it out of the group stages, though I would say that popularity is obviously a concept that is not just, is not foreign to us. That line for TSM today at the meet and greet, oh boy, that was
incredible.
That's actually the first time I've seen a line stop because there's a staircase and then start.
Pengu up here as the buck. Here comes the EE1D to take Vagary control. It's gonna work great as Uno takes down Dan. Dan not knowing he's exposed from behind, but Karzeka goes for the refrag and gets it. So there's Goga there from the front door to also enact change in this round.
But it's still Shepard and Scyther, the two who have been so clutch in the long run, and Scyther looking to try and start it. Well, he'll get one. He also catches Goga, but the Spaniard with one HP downs him and removes him from the equation. Shepard nestled up in the bomb site, throws out a top. He's from Empire. It's Scyther and Shepard with G2 still having 3, 30 seconds to go. Match still on the line, or map rather, but Shepard misses. Can't control the bearing nine. Karzeka finished off as well. Pengu is down. Fabian is so low that Scyther can be able to come back, but he's going to be spotted from the Valk cam, completely under watch.
Oh!
There's a C4. Fabian just exploding underneath Scyther, and we've got round number 12. It's still a 4-3 game. Tracksinger's being deployed, so Uno gets some of his ability off, or his gadget rather. But he won't get any more, or rather that's Kanto, as Karzeka and Joystick are there, and they line up, and they get knocked down like dominoes. G2 falling, and they'll continue to fall. We're staring at it, indeed, a flawless round. My word. 5-3, the timeout not working. In now, G2 will scramble. They were trying to take out the hatch because they don't have a Thatcher due to Fabian dying early.
Oh, wow.
That could be a very pivotal and crucial mistake. G2 in a battle to the death now as Shepard pops up. He sees one. Oh, he'll absolutely crush Uno. There's another three. Shepard, oh my God. Pengu now in a 1v3. His position given away. And Empire looking to sit pretty amidst the smoke is Pengu. And Empire will do something they hadn't done until insurance should that wall go off. And he's not able to successfully bandit trick it. But then you have Fabian there too. G2 invested an awful lot in holding Piano, more than a lot of teams do. A lot of teams give it up, they fall back, they take cocktail, they play long range towards both of the hatches. Not this case. And G2 could not be shaken from their position. Every single time a fight appeared, it was either Pengu or Fabian taking it, and they were really all that was needed from G2.
Now, it's important to know, 3-3 and Empire are so very close, actually, four rounds away from winning this outright and following a pick like
oh
that.
Oh my God!
I mean, how are you not gonna take the round outright? As Karzeka runs out from the office and Joystick gets his second, Empire are just making this so hard. That's the third for Joystick. Pengu the last alive, and his position is well known. He'll go to Dan, and Empire for the first time in this map. Shepard goes for a rush, eats a lot of damage, but doesn't lose the fight just yet. Pengu alive, but he only gets one. Can he get the second? He's so close, he runs back. The diffuser's low on time. Karzeka's gotta go, but Pengu! An insane clutch! The plant and the perfect post-plant positioning, and G2 win another round. The half ends 3-3. With Shepard still in a great spot to hold it. Pengu's successful, though. Confidence really bleeding through as he positions himself inside of A. He might get a good angle, but no, Shepard's aware, and he repositions. Pengu now actually in a good position to clutch, all things considered. He has 30 seconds, and he can go for an attempted plant. Shepard's slow on the retake. He finally goes for the push, but it's too late. Post-plant now. Things looking better for Pengu. Karzeka and Shepard need to meet up or play the crossfire. C4 used to open up a castle barricade by the front door. That'll give more angles to Shepard, and Pengu's well aware, but he comes off at the perfect moment, allowing Shepard to get the better angle as he peeks towards front door. Pengu's still alive, though, and we're near half the diffuser duration. Karzeka going for the long angle peek, but he doesn't know where his enemy is, and he's just spraying into the wind. Shepard goes for a rush, eats a lot of damage, but doesn't lose the fight just yet. Pengu alive, but he only gets one. Can he get the second? He's so close, he runs back. The diffuser's low on time. Karzeka's gotta go, but
how great Shepard looked as well. And Shepard isn't somebody who's topping the scoreboard in almost any Empire matchup. That's not his role, that's not his job, that's not his duty. But so far, through every single match of this tournament, Shepard has been outstanding. His initiative and his effort falls just short because of how good of a play that was from Pengu. And man, what a motivator that must be for G2. What a heartbreak that must be for Empire. And now that we move and switch sides, G2 might have the wind at their back for the remainder of this matchup. Round 7, G2's first defense, and we'll go upstairs to Armory. To have had a resurgence, at least over the course of Season 10 and the online play that we've witnessed. Teams going to it with far greater reliability than ever before, as there was always a reluctance to seemingly defend that site, because once you lose office, the rest of the site can go so quickly, and a lot of teams have been very good at being able to open office up. In this instance, I want to see what is going to be brought from the table here, or brought to the table here, rather, from Empire. They're finally bringing the Maestro.
We gotta highlight his play downstairs. The fact that he not only managed to deny the bandit trick, but then follow that up with this nade right here. Karzeka, I believe, was... No, not down. He was just prone. So having him eliminated was fantastic. Big thing, though, is that Empire didn't put any barbed wire on the cache stairs, which allowed for that double kill that Uno then got as he pushed up those cache stairs. Not only no barbed wire, no lesion traps, no player just holding cache stairs. I mean, there are a lot of... won't be able to hit the site, which is really important.
Drone him again for good measure as Dan was detected by the EOD. He's got some covering fire from Joystick on White Stairs, and you know how good Joystick plays in that spot, especially with the carbine in hand. But I don't think they are aware that Joystick's there. Fabian wins the fight, goes for two, he ties them both together. He'll trudge on forward looking for more, and he finds a third. Who else is in his line of sight? It's Karzeka, but Kanto will sweep up, and G2 puts them.
Karzeka going for the long angle peek, but he doesn't know where his enemy is, and he's just spraying into the wind. Shepard goes for a rush, eats a lot of damage, but doesn't lose the fight just yet. Pengu alive, but he only gets one. Can he get the second? He's so close, he runs back. The diffuser's low on time. Karzeka's gonna go, but Pengu! An insane clutch! The plant and the perfect post-plant positioning.
Cross, we indeed love seeing it.
Oh no.
I love how he's wearing the Chonka helm. Dude, my immersion right now, all-time high.
Oh! He flipped the helmet!
Oh my god!
Let's hear it!
Oh! 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 Please, please, just one!
Take the duel!
Just one! Do it! Do it!
No!
Right! No!
The turret falls again.
Cross, we indeed love seeing it.
Oh no.